So yeah, I started out as a farmer, like a veggie, a veggie grower, and involved in a lot of urban farming. And that's how I learned that soil is degraded. We have a major problem. Most of the soil that we need to grow our food, that farmers need, is degraded and is, it's like 60 or 90% or something of soil globally is degraded. So I became aware of this issue as I was getting involved in agriculture. I also became aware that, degraded soils can contain contaminants, like different metals and other types of contaminants that can, impact our health if we're eating food that's grown in these contaminated soils. So I thought, what can we do about this? And that question, what can we do about soil to improve soil health, to reverse soil degradation, led me to fungi. I did not know anything about fungi, 12 years ago. I started learning and just, I learned that to work with fungi to clean up and restore soil, you have to know how they live. And so I started learning about fungal ecology, and I started growing a lot of mycelium. And my life kind of switched to being this person that, basically is spreading mycelium everywhere.
Spawning.
Yeah. And so I just, for those of you who may not be familiar, I'd love to take a little journey. I mean, a lot of the living parts of fungi, so the mycelium that Ivo mentioned, are out of sight. So we don't know about them and the essential roles they play. So if you can just imagine, like, beneath your feet right now is probably, hopefully, a web of fungal mycelium connecting all the plants on the farm and the trees. Those ones are called mycorrhizal. So myco, fungal, rhizal, related to roots. And you may have heard of, like, the wood wide web and these notions of mother trees and these networks of fungi that are communicating between plants. Yeah, so those are really important fungi, hopefully beneath us right now. We also have decomposer fungi, like the same kind of guys you're seeing in this basket here. Decomposer fungi decompose organic matter. They break down dead plants and turn it into soil. And we really would not have soil if it were not for these decomposer fungi. There's so many other fungi that all work together. I mean, in nature, every organism's life creates food and habitat for another organism's life. And so really my work and my research today and over the last decade or so has been about basically allying with these fungi, these different types of fungi, and trying to relink cycles so that we are, for instance, growing protein-rich food and medicine on safe waste, solving two problems there.
And you mean substrate in that waste you're talking about?
Yes.
Okay,
absolutely.
So explain substrate, what that means for, what is substrate?
Substrate is the food for the mushroom you're trying to grow. The mushroom is just the fruit body. The substrate is the food that the mycelium, that living part, is growing on and getting its food from. So for all decomposer fungi, their food is carbon, basically. It's dead stuff, dead plants. So that means that we can use everything from spent coffee grounds to, sawdust from the lumber industry, from agricultural waste, like, I don't know, corn stalks, to grow food, to grow these mushrooms. And then the best part is you can then apply that mycelium once the blocks have stopped fruiting. We can then apply that mycelium to degraded soil, and these decomposers will go to work on organic contaminants like diesel. They'll go to work and build really healthy soil and help restore soil.
Well, so that's a good point. Not only are they taking contaminants out of the soil in that instance, or in some instances, you said, I think lead, sort of grabbing it so that it stays out of the water system, but they can also help regenerate soil, increase the organic content, so that for those folks at home with the garden or farmers generally, they're increasing, the capacity of that soil to grow, like adding compost. That's essentially the same concept.
Yeah.
Which is brilliant.
Yeah, it increases the capacity of the soil to hold moisture. I'm working on a number of projects in California right now, working with fungal mycelium to help prevent toxic, like metal contaminated ash from all the wildfires from getting into watersheds. I'm working
because the mushrooms grab them.
Yeah, well, that same web that we're talking about, it has passageways that are smaller than anything a human can produce. So it's essentially a giant filter in the soil that can basically grab on to metals and whether it's living or dead and block them from running off into streams. The other thing too is that the mycorrhizal fungi I mentioned that connect with plants and help them grow also play really neat roles. Part of my research in LA, where there's a lot of contaminated sites, you may know.
Let's not pick on LA. That's probably true of every
it's
major
true
city,
everywhere.
Right? Every urban area.
It's true everywhere. It's an uncomfortable reality to face. But for me, it's very inspiring that we can ally with life. We can work with fungi and plants and other organisms to help clean up soil and protect human health as well, and sort of support the regeneration of ecosystems. Well, fungi are fascinating. They really evade categorization. So what I mean is that fungi will change. There's four main sort of categories of fungi by ecological role. So there's the decomposers, the mycorrhizal fungi, the parasitic fungi, and the endophytes, endo inside fight plant. They grow inside of plants. Parasites are really interesting because, I mean, some really powerful medicinal fungi like cordyceps, right? Y'all know the one that takes over the brains of insects and makes them act all weird and crawl up high, and then the mushroom fruits out of their brain and spreads spores, and then we eat it. It's like a very powerful medicine. So that's a parasite. You could consider chaga a parasite as well. But really, parasites play really important ecological roles. If we zoom out, right, they help maintain balance. Every time a tree is felled in a forest, soil can be created. There's habitat for, woodpeckers and owls to burrow and all sorts of other life. So, I think parasites are often maligned, but if we zoom out, they play really important roles. And just again, on that, the fungi-defying categorization, I mean, I've been learning lately that there's like decomposer fungi. So fungi that typically would grow on, like leaf litter or a dead tree or something, that totally cycle through different categories. They'll at some stage be a parasite, or they're growing on a living tree. They want to eat it, so they'll take it down eventually. Then they're in the soil. They'll fruit a mushroom, throw spores to get back up in the tree, and then crawl inside and live in the leaves of the tree as endophytes, not causing harm, but actually existing in an exchange. Like they get room and board in exchange for helping the plant photosynthesize. So I could go on about how amazing fungi are in helping bring balance into ecosystems and just really defying categorization.
But specifically with the chaga mushrooms and the birch trees, which seems parasitic and latch on the way you said. And what has happened is because of the popularity of the mushroom, there's been a lot of harvesting in the wild. And actually, as you said, it's sort of a band-aid. When those are harvested in that way, sometimes it creates potential harm for the tree.